Oh, there it is, there it is. Nobody at the top of Gray's Peak. That means it's getting colder up here. People are at school, people in work. I must say, it's kind of nice to have a summit to myself. Oh, baby. I saw, so on the way up here, listening to an audiobook by David McCullough, and I learned on the way up that the old adage, no time like the present, was first shared in 1696. So I'm using that adage today, no time like the present, to try out Unived Elite Gel right now. 2-to-1 carbohydrate ratio, 800 milligrams of betaine, I hope I'm saying that right, 512 milligrams of electrolytes. Oh my goodness, I'm pretty excited. This is the Berry Blast flavor, 190 calories. I feel like that's pretty high. So let's rock and roll. How's this taste? Whoa. Hello. Oh man, inspired by nature, based on research. Whoa, that's got a kick to it, baby. Oh wow, it tastes good. It tastes good. Ooh, but it has a kick. Oh my goodness. Ooh. All right. See you at the top of Tori's. And super psych. All right, I did get to the top of Tori's Peak today, but I did not film it. It actually was getting pretty chilly. So the fall weather is definitely in the air here in Colorado. So I actually booked it off the mountain as quick as I could. All right, moving the temps, putting the Terra Ultra G260s from Innovate up there. For today's run was 22 miles, 5,500 feet of vertical gain. There it is on your screen in kilometers, basically a little over 35 kilometers. And there it is in meters as well for the vertical gain. So a solid day, but I posted on Strava. And by the way, holy guacamole, holy guacamole, the Polar Vantage 5. It was a special day. Now listen, it's too much data for me. I don't know what's going on with the watch, and I will learn it, okay? But it's gonna take weeks, if not months, to figure out all of the different data points that this watch can do, but it was pretty neat being able to glance at my watch and see some of the stats. Honestly, if I had to say right now, I think the heart rate was accurate. I was going pretty chill today, pretty calm, and I was just glancing, listening to my breathing, and again, I'm not a heart rate guy, but I think it was actually accurate. So that's just my gut feeling as far as how I was breathing and glancing at the watch. So it was fun day in the Polar Vantage 5. Today's topic about finding your niche in running is critical. It's critical, especially if you love to push yourself and be competitive and frankly compete against other people, whether you're 75 years old or 15 years old. It doesn't matter. Like, some of us need an outlet in our lives and need that competition. I know I do. I love competing and shaking my competitor's hand afterward and just like going battling back and forth. So finding your running niche is the focus of what I'm about to share. I will get you my first impressions of the Terra Ultra G260s very, very soon. And now, in bringing up this topic about how to find your running niche, I'm simply planting seeds, hopefully, to help you reflect on who you are, what your strengths are, because frankly, I've made a couple mistakes in my running career and I wanna help you avoid those, okay? But first, we've gotta define some of the different niches that are out there. Now listen, we could start all the way down at the 100 meters, but as you know, I'm not a sprinter, so I'm gonna leave the sprinting to another YouTube channel out there. I'm sure there's sprinting YouTube channels out there. I'm gonna start honestly at, like, let's say the 800 meters. I feel like that is the beginning of distance running, in my opinion. So the 800 meters all the way up, craziness. Listen to me now, and you might, if you're not familiar with all the different genres out there, yes, there are multi-stage, multi-day races out there where you're literally racing for a week straight every single day. So we're not gonna talk too much about those, but we're talking 800 meters, 1500, 3K, 5K, 10K, half marathon, 10 mile, half marathon, marathon, 25K, 50K, we're gonna, 100K, 100 mile, 200 mile, 200 plus mile, multi-day races. And then in all of those distances, everybody, we're talking different surfaces: grass, track, road, trail, desert. So there's it's vast. You want to throw in another factor? We're talking different elevation gains, okay? So you might have a 50K, you might have a 100 mile world record on the track, which those do exist. You literally run around a track for 100 miles. In fact, a race is coming up in Arizona soon to, what is the name? I'm not gonna remember. I'll put it on the screen for you. But then you have the 100 mile races like the Leadville 100, which starts at 10,000 feet, or Hard Rock 100. So what I'm getting at is that the running space is vast, and I frankly was unaware in high school. I was unaware in college, and I wish I would have watched this vlog right now when I was younger to simply wrap my mind around the fact that, hey, if I'm not excelling, and this was me in college at the University of Colorado, like, I was doing okay, but I wasn't excelling, especially, let's say, at like the 5K on the track. Or even, frankly, like, for some reason, I struggled with the 10K on rolling grass courses. Like, I don't think I had the leg strength yet, because running on grass is a lot different than running on dirt or pavement, for sure. Like, grass, you gotta be strong. Like, it's different. So if you're not excelling at a particular distance or on a particular surface at a particular elevation gain, you might need to pivot. And that's what I did. I pivoted after college. I took a little bit of downtime. I wasn't racing, but eventually I found my way to the ultra running scene, which is, let's just say, 50K and above, okay? So 30 miles and above, those types of races. And I did well there, but now, everybody, I'm pivoting a little bit back. So in 2018, I attempted a 100 mile race, my first 100 mile race. And I'm gonna talk more about that in a minute. But now in 2019, I'm niching down again to mountain running, particularly the 6 mile to half mile uphill courses. That appears to be kind of a little bit of a sweet spot for me. Uphill, 6 miles to half marathon so far. I'm intrigued to go further, but right now that's where I'm honed in. Okay, now let me just give you a couple quick tips for how to find your niche. First of all, seek out an elder, somebody with wisdom, a sage advice, somebody with a lot of experience in the running world who can guide you, not a coach per se, but maybe a mentor who could guide you along the path of finding what your strengths are within running. Okay, so that's tip number one. Tip number two, fail, DNF, go try. At the end of the day, you have to go try different types of races. And eventually, you might have, now, I don't wanna say go get injured, but frankly, I've done that, where I push myself and push myself, trying to find my way and my niche, and yeah, I've ended up injured. Even 4 months ago, getting ready for Cleveland. But failure is okay. And like last year, okay, here we go. Run Rabbit Run 100 mile race. I DNF'd at 50 miles for a lot of different reasons. But that was a learning moment. And I think I've accepted that. And okay, I'm gonna come back to that in a second. Tip number three is follow your natural instinct or your natural attraction to the different types of running. Now that's kind of like philosophical and pie in the sky talk, but what I'm saying is I am naturally attracted to the mountains. Like I for some reason that uphill running, it's ingrained in me. I think it's probably because how I was raised with my dad up in the mountains hiking a lot. I think that's where it probably comes from. But you just have to stop, think, reflect. Wow, why do I love track workouts? Maybe it's because my mom, who when I was like a toddler, she was still doing track workouts to get ready for a local 5K. So I was always hanging around the track. And so that follow that natural attraction, I bet it will lead you to more joy within your racing and therefore more success at the end of the day. Because if you're not joyful and happy in your racing, you're probably, I just say it, you're probably not going to succeed. You're not going to reach your full potential in my opinion, all right? So those are my three tips for finding your niche. And yes, right now, all right, should I just ask this now? Okay, here we go. Question of the day, have you found your running niche? And this is, if you have time to type, please do. Especially those who have found your running niche and maybe share how you found it. Like, how did you discover, okay, I'm a really great trail half marathon runner, or I'm a really solid road 1 mile runner, like racer. Like there's road 1 mile races out there and I just do really well in those. So if you can share there, or question number two, if you haven't found your niche, have you ever even thought about this topic of niching down in your running to figure out what you love? No, I'm not saying you can't go out and try different. In fact, I encourage that, but it's eventually, I bet you'll discover, okay, I really enjoy doing, you know, 10Ks on the track or whatever, or cross country. You know, like I'm actually really interested in maybe hopping in some USATF cross country races somehow this fall. I don't know. It's intriguing to me right now. So, and yes, right now, as we speak, I have a tension. There's tension in my life. You're watching it play out literally every single day on Strava and here on YouTube. The tension is the mountains, Pikes Peak Ascent, and Amsterdam, and this dream I've had to someday run in the Olympic trials. Like, that's always been a dream of mine, but I have this mountain passion, and so I'm trying to bring the two together right now, and it's a tension. And frankly, the drama is still playing out right before myself and you here on YouTube every day until I run that race in Amsterdam. Like, I don't know what's gonna happen. I do not know, but I'm trying to find my way. And yes, not being afraid to fail and not be like Cleveland Marathon. I put that in the category of a little bit of a failure because I did not arrive on the starting line healthy and I was unable to race it. So I'm niching down and trying to figure this out with all of you. I hope that made sense. I'll stop talking. That was a lot of riffing there. Thanks for riffing with me. But I think it's important to, especially if you wanna, I don't know. It's just, okay. At the end of the day, running should be fun, right? So I think you will have more fun in your running if you find the discipline or the genre or the niche of running that you excel at. That's just my humble opinion. All right, thank you for being here. Thanks for watching today. I love you all. All right, we're gonna give you a couple vlogs. One on the left is mental strength, okay? And I think mental strength does play into finding your niche. So that's gonna be a mental strength vlog. And then the one on the right is my DNF at the Run Rabbit Run 100, which I think is happening this weekend. So anyway, thank you for being here. Thanks for watching. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.